Here, if you say you have gay tendencies, you will not likely find acceptance. But if you are in the Western world, who have gay tendencies, say, oh. If you feel like transgender, yeah, so there's a cultural bias. But there are people sometimes who feel trapped. What we need to do is a deconstruction mind therapy. Let them see that what you are feeling. Like the girl I told you about, she feels 70% male. She behaves 70% male. But the genitals indicate that she's a girl. So what we need to do is to be able to deconstruct our mind. Whether you are a female gender or a male gender, live a useful life. Herself in a part whereby indulgent lifestyle is not ideal. So, two boys, of course, the girl can go from this location to the other location to go and meet themselves as family friends. So they were quite free. So during the holidays, they would come to the house, blah, blah, blah. So one day, the mother slept, woke up, bed up the night, was telling some strange stuff. Interestingly, they didn't lock the door. She met that incorporation. And she fainted. They had to call me dead of the night. What can we do? What can we do? So, both gay and lesbianism is here. But the percentage has not been proven. There is also people who does both heterosexual and sexual, homosexual. There are also people who is doing it for money. There are also the big sisters luring the guys because they've been frustrated in relationships. And there are people who just want to experiment. The street where you took him, I've witnessed a matured woman kissing a girl of about 18 right on this other street. And in the morning, passionate kiss. And so I took time to let the girl walk out of the gate and I tried to engage her in conversation. She was very hostile, very, very hostile. And that's why we also know that they are frustrated. So I promised her whenever we discuss, I will not only keep your secrets, I will help you get out of it, and I'm going to give you money. So I can't not choose. I said, well, a friend introduced her to the mother. And madam does her well, if she gets home now, I will give the money to daddy and mommy. So, fine. So, the end of the story is that they are recruiting girls in the university. And that's why it is important we focus on capacity building for girls from the age of 8, because they enter secondary school faster. We've also had experience in a particular secondary school that gay activities is like normal after school hours. Last year, we were able to do out-of-home outreach. One of the cases reported to me was a boy of 11 year old caught in homosexual acts twice. How he got out to do it, how he learned to use Vaseline to assault boys of 7, boys of 9, God knows. But he is in a correctional center. So, like the issue of depression, like all other issues, it could also be DNA-driven, wide behavior. Some people just enjoy going through or against normal patterns of life. What do we have to do for them? One, affirm them. Two, let their parents first and foremost come in for behavioral clinics. Because until the parents understand what is happening, you truly cannot help that child. And the third is to start engagement with the child or the person involved, just like we do with masturbations, take you through a series of therapy that makes you become wholesome and useful in life. There is nothing. There's a particular place they take them for deliverance center, and we are saying sorry. Deviant behavior is not just medical, it's not just spiritual, it's not just behavioral, is all encompassing. Can we look at holistic solution? Because the child comes out hating the deliverance session much more than you can.